I have mentioned a product in many of my videos called coarse vermiculite, and a lot of you know this is 1/3 of the soil mixture for the square foot garden soil mix. The other two components are peat moss and a blended compost. And so I just wanted to touch on coarse vermiculite today and hopefully provide you with a couple of sources where you can get it if you've had a hard time finding it. Now remember, this is an organic product. It's very similar to mica, and it helps retain air and moisture in your soil. Vermiculite is also very unique in that it has properties which makes various types of minerals available to the growing plant. And so let's just take a closer look here. I'd like to show you the difference between vermiculite and perlite. Now on the left here is coarse vermiculite, and then we have on the right, the white is the perlite, and then here at the top, this very fine powder almost is fine vermiculite. There's one more grade of vermiculite, and it's medium grade, but what we use for the soil mixture is coarse vermiculite. Now, perlite is a completely different product, and it is what you will find most of the times in the commercially bagged potting soil mixes, and you can easily see that on your labels. Sometimes they will put vermiculite in there, but most of the times they use perlite. And the reason why you're using either vermiculite or perlite is to keep that soil nice and light so it won't compact. So perlite is actually like a volcanic glass. So I wanted to compare the two. And so in a mason jar, I went ahead, I put a little funnel along with a coffee filter and 1 cup of coarse vermiculite. And to that, I added exactly 1 cup of water. And you'll notice that it's not puddling up or anything like that. The coarse vermiculite is actually absorbing that water. It drained out, and then I decided to go ahead and measure what drained out, and I ended up with 3/4 cup of water. So 1 cup of vermiculite absorbed 1/4 cup of water. And you'll notice here too that it is still nice and light. It's not all sticking together like a big clump or anything like that, but it's visibly very wet. And now for the perlite. And so I went ahead and did the same thing, poured in 1 cup of water. You'll notice that the perlite tends to start floating. We want our additive to stay inside our soil mixture. So a lot of times perlite will float to the top of your soil. And so I let it drain through and measured it, and it was almost still right at 1 cup. Perhaps the coffee filter absorbed the little bit of water there, because I think most of the water drained right through the perlite, which is fine for keeping the soil from getting compacted, but it's also nice if it has some kind of moisture retaining property to it. So I contacted the folks over at Palmetto Vermiculite Company to see if they had a source for my subscribers where they could get some coarse vermiculite online. And they provided me with a couple of companies that sell it 1 bag at a time. Of course, you'll have to pay for shipping, and I'll leave links below the video for you. I am not getting any kind of sponsorship or credit for this. I just know that it's a hard product to get a hold of sometime, so I wanted to make sure to try to help you guys out. So this first company here, I think they have it on sale through the month of May here in 2018. I don't know that it'll still be on sale in June. But when I calculated it with shipping to my house, it really was only a few dollars more than where I have to go across town to buy it locally. So it just depends on the convenience factor, if you want to have it delivered to your door or not. And then there's this other company too that also sells it. Just buy 1 bag if you want to, or you get a quantity discount. So I've mentioned that I've seen it on Amazon before. Now I am an Amazon associate, so if you order through my link from Amazon, I will get a a tiny credit for that, but I don't know that I can recommend this brand. I've never tried it. It has conflicting reviews about whether it's coarse or medium or fine when it's supposed to be coarse. So I've only used Palmetto Vermiculite before. So anyway, I will leave a link for that. I think it has free shipping. They end up costing about the same, about $34, $35 a bag, and it's a really big bag. It probably takes up half of a bathtub. I think some I read in a review. This is 4 cubic feet of vermiculite, and it's very lightweight, so you don't have to really, worry too much about moving it around once it's delivered to you. So I hope that information helped you out. And as a reminder, I have a lot of other playlists over on my channel. Many of them are for square foot gardening, and of course, a lot of recipes are over there too. So, thank you so much for watching, and y'all have a beautiful day.